Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Creeper World 4. That is right, we are back heading in the colony section yet again for the next CW4 PF beta. I'm assuming they're all betas. AOO map. PF, of course, being Particle Fleet. Let's see what's going on. Now with the biggest weakness of the Odin's operation removed, it is time to find us enough ship licenses to allow Odin to build a proper fleet. That's right, it's time to go salvaging. So very, very cool. Let's give this a go. And it says it's a quicker one, so let's see how it goes. Hopefully my computer can handle it. Maybe it'll be a little bit smaller. maybe. You never know. Let's check out what also has changed. There are some better, more reliable energy collectors. Most fantastic. Gotta love it. The ship movement has been changed, so I have no idea how it's been changed. I have not checked it out. So, yeah, we're going to have to check it out and, see what happens. And many general refinements to ensure that everything is acting stable. So, most fantastic. It's the first time I've actually read this last line. So, thank you, Catfax, for giving additional willpower to continue making the series. Seriously, thank you for making them. It is incredible. The story is fantastic. I have no idea how you do any of this in the Creeper world. Blows my frickin' mind. Thank you so much, and everyone who enjoys it. Feel free to say hi to Vertu in the comments. I'm sure Vertu will probably comment on this. He tends to give me a breakdown of how poor I performed on these maps, or well. But you know, I have a lot to learn, and I always appreciate it. So yeah, let's get going with Listore though. Admiral, look, it's a batch of barrier totems. Wow. What marvelous pieces of technology. Oh, sorry. Always wanted to see one myself and maybe try to tinker with it. As grand as they are, we cannot forget their coincidental arrival with the Vertu Menace, and we will certainly encounter more as we probe deeper. Everyone, briefing starts now.
Good news, we have not encountered enemy shipyards yet. Nothing but particle emitters in terms of hostiles. Fantastic, no ships. I'm okay with that. The black box info cache is buried where you said it would be, and I have marked its location for evacuation.
Good. Since Vertu is ever expanding, areas that are relatively shadow will eventually become deep. Hostile territories of Vertu. Oh my. At least theoretically. We must make the most of the limited resistance. We will grab that info cache, assess its data, or data, depending, and move on to other black box sites.
It is rather concerning how we encountered barrier totems so soon. They were usually found deep within Vertu territory. These should still be very shallow territories. Yet another mystery of the Vertu War Machine.
Very much so, but we mustn't dwell on it for too long, as Tycon said from his return of the expedition. Time is a valuable resource when dealing with the Vertu, as they will always respond to the slightest touch. I personally have heard many of his harrowing experiences ever since they got on Vertu's radar in the Nexus region of Beep. Space and I would rather not live. Space and I would rather not live those experiences myself. Beep space and I would not rather live those experiences myself. Okay, there we go. Missed the comma in my head. Battle stations, everyone. We're going in. Dismissed.
Okay, so we are going in. We are back to a nice little map again. Nice background. We are just in space. That is it. We are free flying along this spatial path, and it looks like we just have emitters. I'm assuming we can't fly through these, and neither can the particles. I'm kind of hoping that's the goal. So it's just a little windy path. We have a particle emitter. Well, I guess we should see, what is it? 0.17 seconds, so that seems like a rather strong one, hopefully. One, and then one every 0.5 seconds, so that should be essentially two every second. And then one every 3 seconds, so this should be a super weak one in theory. We have the info cache buried over here. Now, there is nothing generating creep over here, so I'm assuming the ships themselves will be able to handle this creep because they don't do very well on the creep themselves. Although we do have the capability to build some things, so do we actually have space? So it is actually possible for us to maybe build some towers and just fly them over there as well. You know, just do a little landing party. That's also a potential viable option. But of course, this is a particle fleet map, which means we need particle fleet units. Now, we have a 3 energy, 6.2 energy. I think that's the one that I would rather have. But I'm just going to go sort of here. Hopefully it builds this right away and builds that. And then we'll sort of move from there. Kind of want to build the energy up right away and then plan. Whew, there we go. We are destroying the rocks in our way as well because, you know, that is always going to be a problem. There we go. Can we... Ooh, it actually moves up and down. Looks a lot nicer. Okay, I've lost a little bit of health, not too much, but we have built up what we wanted to. I'm taking the damage just so I can build that up. Fly it on out of here. This does seem quite better. I mean, it seems actually pretty fantastic if you ask me. We are in a pretty big deficit right now, I'm guessing, because we are charging up our lasers, so that's pretty fantastic, gotta love it. And we can even toss down some towers. This will sort of connect us up to the power, get us this without sending our base in, which I kind of want to hope to do. Just get as much bonus power as possible. Plus, this will help us build some cannons. Why not? So this will be what we need there. And yeah, we also will start to need our good elements. I took a little bit of damage here, but nothing too terrible. Whoa. Pirate bait info cache obtained. Check the extra backdoors in its code. Input some coordinate codes in its console. Say no to run them. And bam, we got the backdoor open. Backdoor code for the black box info cache. Jennifer's Randbury has been quite effective in being pirate bait. So we got pirate bait. Does that give us a new thing? No, I guess that's just bait for us because we went there. I was hitting all of the obstacles, damaging my Odin, of course, although my ammo is fairly fine. Hopefully it'll start rebuilding itself, and hopefully by connecting everything up, we will be pretty good, because we do need to start building some units, right? Let's get these going right away as well. I'm going to connect that up to there, just in case. I'm definitely going to want it on the base, but yeah, we'll see. I think with the towers that we have... we should be pretty good. I am still not the best with spinning this bad boy around. And look at that. Is that our Odin health bar? Super, super cool. I do love that. But here we go. Although my ammo is dropping pretty rapidly, and I'm just a little surprised by that. But, you know what, Odin? Whoa. Stop right there. Perfect. How are these coming along? Are these being built as we want? They are. We are in a pretty massive deficit, but we only have limited power, as we can see. And I never connected that one up, so let's connect that bad boy up. Oh, it got particle, like, while being built. Or no, it's getting hit by debris. So that would be it. But again, we have a solid base now, and our power. A little lacking, but we also do have our towers taking care of things, which is amazing. So, ooh, we're even starting to store power. If we're starting to store power, you know that means we can use it. Well, we're not storing too much, so maybe we do want to just finish these bad boys off first. They're not doing so bad. Well, they're not doing poorly. It's just always more in terms of energy. Oh, jeez. Come on. I just want to build this one. And this one. Although that one, yeah. Yeah, build those up. Yes, more power. More free power. I love it. So the question is, if we leave, will these build towers for us? That I don't know. But what are you? You are a 3 energy collector, so not a great one. But I just want to get my aircraft sorted, right? Oh, yeah. We have one lathe and one Yeovan left to build. We should probably start the Yeovan soon. Maybe here will work. Maybe put it out here. No, let's do it right there. That might sort it out if that collector does anything wild. But I think we're pretty good. And again, I think we're handling things pretty nicely. I just want to get to the point where things are fairly stable. Let's also just toss you down there. Maybe that'll work, because it does look like our usage jumps up and then down sporadically. So maybe that's a thing. Plus, one destroyer has been completed, of course. So with a completed destroyer, I am feeling substantially more comfortable. And holy moly, it's already, like, super clear to me seeing these improvements. Like the actions and such, I think it looks amazing. And it's pretty evident, to me at least, of the improvements that we've made. So truly fantastic, incredible work on the part of Vertu in not only developing this, but refining it even further. Truly, an incredible actions and things like that. It just blows me away. So... just again, thank you for just everything. It's truly amazing. Let's just toss a couple of these down again. We might as well start building them up. We're gonna want them eventually, I suppose. So if we ever have a storage, because that's the thing, we're building these two. We're actually getting a storage over time. So that's why I'm kind of building. Like, look at that. Our deficit went to 0.01 for a little bit. Now we're gaining a storage again. So I'm just sort of trying to use all of the... Yeah, all of the capabilities that we have. With the lathe, though, once the lathe is complete, I am going to try and take this out with the two ships and the lathe, and the Odin will come in slightly behind, as the Odin does. Although the Odin is the most powerful ship, and all of that jazz, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. There we go, look at that, we have so much energy now. And the lathe should be getting there? Almost. Once we're good, We're on the go. We are on the warpath. So, 1, 2, 3. Squad of that. Beautiful. And look at that. We already have a large, fairly large, I would say, amount of cannons, you know, to just to do a drop at the end. I think that's going to be a pretty big help. And there is our lathe. It does look like energy cometh, so let's start the assault. Fingers crossed, though. Again, this is the one that's 0.17. It's 0.17 seconds, and yet it looks like it is way, way slower than that one, which is 1 every second. So again, I think it is inverse. That's kind of my guess. I don't know for sure, but that's kind of how I feel about it. Yovan, how you doing? You are at almost there, not quite there. Ooh, we are taking some hits. There are some particles coming, but look at that. Look, we can see the energy flying out this way now, which is pretty awesome. It looks like the range has been increased, which I do really like. And let's see, maybe if we move this lathe up a little bit more. Their health is still looking pretty good. We just need to get the lathe in range. There we go. So this will get us the energy collector over here, which is awesome. We are taking pretty big hits to these destroyers, though. So hopefully that will also heal the destroyers, not just anything else. I do want this lathe. Right, let's finish that. Good. And let's move that way, because there we go. The lathe is now targeting the emitter. Let's see how that holds out. Again, we're getting super, super close to our goal of having our entire fleet, our particle fleet, if you will. But the lathe has taken some damage, but that's okay. It looks like it held on, and I think it should be fairly all right now. Let's just move those in front, of course, for safety purposes. Move in the oven as well, and we'll even get our Odin on the go. So, we'll toss these down. If they get built, they get built. If they don't, they don't. It is what it is. It's not the end of the world. I'm not super worried about it, but... Now we have our fleet. Wow, that is a really long connection. How does that even work? Oh my gosh. Is that because they should be getting power? Oh no, it's just that long? Is that how the new connection range? Wow, look at that. They were super small before. And yeah, that's pretty amazing if you ask me. Again, just it's just gorgeous. I find it. And let's start the assault patterns, right? Yovan is way faster than everything else, of course. Oh, and let's definitely move this up. We wanna come as a group, you know? So Yovan is up. Destroyers can move on up ever so slightly, and the lathe can then move up from behind. We'll even move the Odin up as well, as it has a lathe cannon, I believe. There we go, Odin doing its thing. Lathe should add to that beam. Hopefully any second. Oh, the Odin, there we go. Double assaults, and we're already working on this, which will then lead us to a collector. And we'll just make our way down. So what do we have next? We have one every second and a one every second. So we do have both of these. Normally I would say go for this one next, but I think, again, hug your walls, because that's a lot going on over there. So we'll take out what we can, but I think we have established our victory right here, right now. We do... Alright. Health-wise, health has restored itself too, which is amazing. So let's take our standard squad. We'll move Destroyer, Lathe. We'll move the Yeoman in behind, and we'll move the Odin in as well. I do tend to like to lead with the Destroyers. I do believe they're, you know, that's sort of their purpose. You know, sort of the general assault tankier ships. At least that's how I feel. Please let me know if I'm very wrong in this. Going over there? I do really want to go over there, but I think, again, hugging the wall-ish, I think, is key. So let's see. One, two, and lathe. Again, the Yovan is super fast, which is why I saved it for last. Although I probably could have moved the Yovan a little bit sooner, of course. But now, with everything in place, I think that should be pretty good. Now the question is, will the lathe... Yes, we are immediately getting our power, which should be good. Always want your power. Power, good. Power, very, very good. And we'll move our next squad up. So move up. That should move our destroyers up. Should move the other lathe up. And we should have a clear victory. Oh, there we go. Another set down. Glorious days are here again. So this is where it's getting a little spooky. There are quite a lot of particles here. So let's take a little light. Again, we want to primarily focus on some of these units, but again, this area, I would rather come from the right side. Again, this is, I'm considering this a wall, so maybe we will focus on that, right? If we put like a destroyer, the lathe over there to sort of reset our trajectory, if you will. We'll even toss the Yovan over here right now that everything is almost in place and moving. With all of our ships basically on top of each other, it is pretty destructive. It feels pretty strong, I think. And yeah, we'll just keep the shift going, right? Move the first squad, wait just for a few seconds, let them get a little bit away, and then the Yovan really catches up super fast, and we should start to get our lanes on. There we go, we do indeed. We are gonna take this particle down. Boom, go for the energy. And yeah, I'm feeling strong, feeling good. Cannot complain about that whatsoever. It's a little funny seeing everything just right on top of each other, but you know, that's the name of the game. Put the lathe in behind, get our Odin moving now. Again, the Odin's slightly faster as well, so that's why I tend to save that for later. It does seem like the Destroyer and the Lathe kind of travel at the same speed, but look at that Yovan comparatively, right? Wow. Does that still have a connection to the base? Oh no, we do have a lot of particles flying over here. Interesting. So, oh, we lost a collector. We lost two collectors. Oh my. That's perfectly fine. We're gonna correct that. But first, I think we're gonna try and do some victory elapse with our units here. So, you know what, Yovan, just get your butt up there. You are needed to assist, of course. And not quite at this one. Actually, yeah, we are now taking it down. Does this have a new health bar? because it looked like there was a little health bar. Yes, it does. Look at it. It has a new... There's even a new health bar that shrinks like... Holy moly. So freaking cool. We'll finish this off. Get our squad on over here. Boop, bop, beep. With the Odin. We actually probably don't even need the Odin. I'll just send the Yovan, and I'll send the Odin back this way. And just with that, I don't know if any of these units will make it. But we're just gonna... It's interesting that they're, like, tied over there. Just fly your butts over here. There we go. We have our squad doing their thing. No particles. Oh, that is every 3 seconds. That is definitely a much slower one. So that is very good news indeed. And... Oh, geez. This took... Oh, my gosh. All of the energy collectors are bad. Oh, no. Not the end of the world, but I want them back. They should be mine. They should be mine. Now, let's test this out, because it looks like this is still green. So if I do this, yeah, look at that. It does just connect up to the frickin' Odin. That's amazing. Oh, that is so cool. Oh, my gosh. I mean, oh, it blows my mind. Blows my mind. So super, super amazing. I can't say that enough. Can these not shoot the creep? I thought they weren't great for creep, but I thought they could shoot the creep. Oh, nope, don't go in. That's bad news. Are you taking damage? Yes, you are. Because they can't shoot down. And we do have cannons coming in, and I really should have the Odin back there. But it's too late now, because I sent that back. I should have sent the lathe back, but you know what? That's fine. Without the Odin, of course, this group is not going to get repowered. So, you know what? That's on them. It's not my fault, I swear. But we're going to, you know, send the next wave in. I think it's pretty good, if you ask me. I was going to just build a Terp over here, and that's still kind of the plan. But look at me. Look at me by sending my Odin back. I've essentially sent these boys to their deaths. To the dooms! But let's just see. Maybe we'll get lucky. Oh, the Odin can shoot the creep, but nothing else can. Interesting. So only the Odin is the creep shooter. Very good to know. We should have plenty of energy here, which is amazing. Again, we have another squad coming in too. So there we go. Power ahoy for the boys. Let's build up all these things. I think? Are you not building? No build? You built everything else. Okay. Let's see, how do we detach then? Charge speed, hover height. I don't remember, because I thought the detach was over here. Oh, click here. Yeah, Rift Lab. Go there. There we go. Now you're doing it. Now you're doing it. Okay, good. That's all I wanted. I just wanted you to do that. So I could build my my Terpimus Prime. So, Terp. Bazinga. Bazanga. Bazunga. All of the good Terps. We have plenty of energy, so I am not worried in the slightest about Terps. And we'll even do our lovely Terra formation, which I guess we just want to be terrain height 1, I suppose. I mean, it's buried here, so Bazinga. And with this connection, we should be fine. It was interesting that it did not connect until I ejected the Rift Lab, though. I'm not sure if that is by design, because it connected elsewhere. It might just be this area. You know, it was a little wonky, so to speak. And, you know, now it's all sorted out. But there we go. Ooh, a whole lot of stuff. Admiral, this info cache is corrupt. Great. Just brilliant. Remember how the expedition team encountered these everywhere? Guess Vertu is ruining the data stored in them, and is the cause of their abundance, especially being so far from beep space. Yes, Yes, I'm aware of the of that part of their campaign. They had to collect 20 specific info caches holding very old data about Nexius, to even locate this the place due to that alone. Fortunately for us, we have knowledge of corporate space while that expedition team was sent into beep space and then ventured into particular part of beep space, the latter called Nexius space, after finding a bunch of info caches involving a location called Nexius. We have the home field advantage in our little expedition. Change course to the military R&D station over at the outer planets. If Vertu is scrubbing our data, we need to go to major installations housing significant quantities of data, or data, so we find some that are in enough of a condition for analysis and repair. Roger that, Admiral. Changing course to Jadafar? I don't know if it's a soft J or not. Maybe we can do some hydrogen skimming. It would do wonders for the health of our jump abilities, possibly speeding up repairs. Ooh, is that like new technology other than ships? Like we get little upgrade? Ooh, that'd be so super cool. Not so fast, Cougar. Sensors detect energy activities over there. We may not be able to stop by for anything other than a quick grab and dash. We have no idea what Vertu does with recently conquered territories, lest we find out they also like to do hydrogen skimming on mass. We can talk more about the situation at Jadafar while we reach it. Prepare for jump, team. Jump at your discretion. Oh my. And you know what? We cleared up pretty much all of the things. I'm actually curious. I do want to put this back in. So if I do that, it should dock. It did. And do we still connect from here? We do. So I just had to disconnect and reconnect for just a second, and it sort of sorted itself out. So that's pretty fantastic. Although, I guess the question is, do we... Oh, look at that. So it's connected to one landmass at a time. Oh, that's so cool. So you can say, this is my home base, and this will have power. But see, if I were to build something here right now, it's not going to build because we're no longer connected. We were connected to here for the entire time because this was sort of home base alpha, if you will. But the moment we got here, we had to disconnect to turn this into the new home base. So very cool to learn. Love that ability, honestly, because it's not so powerful where it's like, it's too much, but it's very powerful in the fact that you can have a home base and not worry about leaving it. Like, for instance, now that I know this, if I were to do this map over, for instance, I just take over our first home base, and we probably could have taken over the first few nodes by ourselves. I'm sorry, I'm just sort of talking while... I'm only building this stuff because I was talking. So, but let's call it here. This is very, very fun. Thank you so much again, Vertu. Love it. Looking forward to more. The improvements are incredible. Just truly, truly, again, baffling. So, super, super cool. Hope everybody enjoyed. Hope you're having a wonderful, wonderful day. Let's riff jump out of here. There we go. Done and dusted. Bazinga. Not bad, actually. 10 minutes. I thought it was... Well, it's been that long. Oh, that's for the destroy. We destroyed everything in 10 minutes. Okay. 14 minutes on the info cache. There we go. So not too bad. You know, I feel pretty good. Vertu did it in 7. So yeah, definitely think once we build our home base, you can start flying off and taking over objectives with the Odin while other things build at your home base, which is so amazing. Love it. Super, super vast improvements. Truly incredible. Take care. Leave a like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And I'll catch you next time.